So Delta 8, I love Delta 8. I think it's absolutely a fantastic. I love the way it makes me feel. I love the way that, I mean, I don't have anything bad to say about it. Like I said, it's a molecule. I mean, you know, it's a molecule. It's, you know, you can't have a bad feel. Molecules can't be good or bad. They just are what they are. What has happened though, is that the people in the hemp industry are seeing that the CBD craze is a failure. From a business standpoint, it's a failure. And so they're looking for a way to monopolize or exploit what they already have been doing in their systems, in their markets, by introducing this novel, which isn't novel, it's always been there, Delta 8. And they're making claims that that Delta 8 is not covered by the Marijuana Tax Act, that it's actually under the hemp bill, because it's not, it only talks about THC, and this is a THC. Well, yes, it is, it's THC. It's still THC, it's just a different, the same number of carbon molecules, they're just in different places, you know, they share their isomers, so they're the same. Where I have a real problem with Delta 8 is the fact that they are trying to separate it out. And because it has such tremendous medical benefit potential for many people, it needs to be regulated so that it's safe and so that it's consistent and so that the labeling is in place and all those things. And that's not happening on the hemp side at all. So they're trying to hijack basically and go around, it's very Eddie Haskell-ish for anybody that remembers, you know, Leave It to Beaver. It's very, you know, it's just not, it just makes you feel icky when you think about the fact that they're exploiting potentially really sick people and for profit in a way that doesn't take into account what's necessary to keep it safe. Delta 8 has tremendous possibilities, and, you know, it is a weaker agonist in some ways, so it's a different type of psychoactivity, so it's a lesser, you know, at the same time.